Earlier this year, Apple demonstrated their position and direction as a spatial computing company with the introduction of the Vision Pro. Tim Cook made a very bold claim that the world is transitioning to a radically new paradigm for computing.
So in the same way that Mac introduced us to personal computing, and iPhone introduced us to mobile computing, Apple Vision Pro will introduce us to spatial computing.
But what is a spatial computer, and why are companies like Apple, Google, and Meta so sure that it's the future? Let's have a look at spatial computing and the future of language. Let's imagine we were walking through a forest and we came across a fallen tree. I point at the fallen tree and I say, "Hey, look at that beautiful couch." Something interesting just happened. By using language, I altered your perception. You now see the sittingness of the fallen tree. In fact, this is what language is for: to share your vision, to manifest your knowledge and imagination in the minds of others, just like augmented reality.
This is a technology which is going to turn out to not be what people think it is. It's going to be a technology for showing each other the inside of our heads, for showing each other our dreams. And a culture cannot evolve any faster than its language evolves. And it cannot be any more glued together than the bandwidth that its languages will tolerate.
The transition from mobile to spatial computing is not the transition from handhelds to wearables, although that will happen too. It's a new way for us to interact with digital information and with each other. Digital information in physical space allows us to communicate with each other at a greater bandwidth than ever before. This is why augmented reality is inevitable. It's what humans do. But there's a dark underbelly to the future of language and augmented reality, at least the way it's built today. Let's talk about positioning and privacy. Augmented reality requires pinpoint 3D positioning for the experience to be shared. If we want to manifest some digital information in physical space and see it the same way, then our devices need to have a consensus about their relative position. But digital devices don't have an inherent understanding of their place in the world, and the GPS can only tell the device what vicinity it's in, and it doesn't work indoors, and it doesn't work in dense environments. To solve the problem of positioning, everyone from Tesla to Apple, from ByteDance to Snap, has turned to the camera. By comparing the visual feed of your device to the centralized databases of these companies, your device can recognize its position. But this means that big tech is looking through our eyes. And soon, the transition from handhelds to wearables will mean that the cameras are on our faces. And that's the plan. AR is an inevitable improvement to our way of communicating with each other, but big tech is plotting to own the very infrastructure of the future of language. Our cognitive liberty is at stake. How can we embrace this powerful technology and maintain privacy if the camera has to be on? We are building the Posemesh, a universal spatial computing protocol for the next 100 billion people, devices, and AI. The Posemesh decentralizes the positioning service in a privacy-preserving and permissionless way. Rather than a giant centralized copy of the world, the Posemesh is a protocol for moving between smaller maps of private domains. Instead of sharing your camera feed with us, you can privately exchange spatial data with the domain that you're visiting or with peers that are in your area. We believe that the Posemesh is a foundational part of the future of the internet and of language itself. But the Posemesh requires a new kind of infrastructure to allow for collaborative spatial computing in a privacy-preserving way. This is live. There are already hundreds of participating nodes in our network today, and it's growing. New applications for the future of commerce, entertainment, and logistics are already being built on the Posemesh, building momentum with the inevitable transition to spatial computing. But how can such a vital decentralized protocol be maintained? How can we trust its many participants? How can we ensure uptime and performance? How can we incentivize people to participate? And practically, how can we reward all of the participants in the Posemesh while enabling the next 100 billion devices to join? To address these concerns, we are building a blockchain-enabled rewards and reputations layer for the Posemesh so that it can serve as a public utility in the service of civilization and not some corporate entity. As we walk into the new era of human communication, we must safeguard our cognitive freedom. Participate in the Posemesh. This is how we win.